Hi, this is Anne with SVG Cut File, and today I'm going to show you how to add a white sticker outline to your design in Cricut Design Space. So what I mean is going from this style to this style. I'm going to show you three ways to do it: with an SVG file, a PNG file with a transparent background, and a JPEG file with a white background. All right, let's get started. Okay, so first I'm going to show you how to do this with an SVG file, and that's a file that ends with .svg. Here's what it looks like. So I'm going to load this in Cricut Design Space. So I'll start up Cricut Design Space, and that'll bring me to this screen. So I'm going to choose New Project, and I'll come down here on the bottom left to Upload, and I'll upload image. And then I'll browse for the image I'm looking for. Here's the SVG file. This is the one that ends in .svg. And I'll open that, and then I'll choose Upload right here at the bottom right. And then I'll click on that and Add to Canvas right down here. I'm on my Layers section right here, and you can see Basic Cut and another Basic Cut. One is a light pink and one is a dark pink. I'm going to hit Command A or Control A to select all the layers. That's select all. And then I'm going to come up here to Offset, right up here at the top. Now, if you're not seeing Offset, it might be time to update your Cricut Design Space, because it should be there if you have the most recent version. So I'm going to choose this, and you can see that it's already added an outline to this, and I think this actually looks really great. Now, there are a few options here. You can specify how big you want that outline to be by just dragging this, or if you want it to be a specific amount, you can just highlight this and type it in. So let's say I want it to be 0.25 inches. We also have the option of doing a corner or rounded outline, or a squared off outline. If I choose this one, you won't see any difference, because this design actually does not have any square corners like this. The pink part is rounded, so we're not going to be able to see that, but you'll notice a difference if you actually have square corners in your design. And this third one, weld offsets, I always do this because I can't think of a reason why you would want them unwelded, so we'll just go ahead and leave this as welded, and I'll apply. Now, when I do this, it automatically does two things. It makes a new layer, which is right over here, and it colors that offset black. And we can change that by going right up here under the operation and choosing this color, and then choosing white if we want a white offset. I think the reason they make it black is because when you change it to white, it instantly becomes kind of hard to see. So I think they wanted to make sure everyone sees it. And honestly, if you're cutting this on a cutting machine, you can make this any vinyl color you want, so it doesn't really matter. Now, if we wanted to do a print and cut on this, all we'd have to do is select all the layers with Command A or Control A, and then do flatten right here. Of course, if I did that, I'd want to change this to white first. So I'll do that. And then we'll select all with Command A. That shows all of them are selected over here. That's Control A on a PC. We'll flatten. And now we have our print and cut right over here. Okay, now I'm going to delete this, and this time I'm going to use a transparent PNG. So I'm going to upload that, and I've got a different version of this same design, and that is right here. And you can see it has a transparent background. I'm going to open that, and this time we'll get a different screen, because PNG and JPEG are both raster formats. SVG is vector, so it allows us to make changes much easier with a vector. We have to do a little work, but it's okay with the PNG. So we have three options here. We can do simple, moderate, and complex. And I'm going to choose complex because I have really thin stripes in here, so I needed to be able to see those easily. And then we'll continue. And this is looking really nice, so I'll apply and continue. And now it's going to ask us, do we want a cut image? This is a vector format, and then this one is the raster. And we want this because we want to do print and cut. So we'll upload that. I'll click on that, and then I'll add to canvas. Okay, and this is coming in really, really big, which is a good thing, because if it's that big, that means it's very high res. It's actually too big to fit on a mat right now, and that's what this little warning is telling us. I'll click it and just make it smaller. There we go. And when we make it small enough, that warning goes away over here. Okay, so we have it right now as about 5 inches by 5 inches. And now we can do the same thing. We'll just come up here to offset. We can see a preview of that offset or sticker outline, and then just do apply. And then it'll be the same process. So we've got the black outline. We want to change this to white. So we'll do that. Bing. And then we can select both things and flatten right here. When we do that, we get a print then cut image. And now we can go ahead and make our sticker. All right, I'm going to delete this and I'll upload one more option. And this one is going to be a JPEG with a white background. So we'll browse for that. I'm going to do the same thing here because this is a raster format. So we have to choose either simple, moderate, or complex. I'll choose complex. We'll continue. And now we have this white background to contend with. So all we have to do to get rid of this is just click in the area here where the white is, and then click in here and click in here. And that's it. Then we can apply and continue. We'll do the same thing. We'll choose the print then cut image. Upload that. This will probably come in really big too. I'll click it and add to canvas. Yes, it's pretty big. So I'm going to scroll down and get this scale tool to make it smaller. Now we can just use our offset. These all look good and I'll apply. Then I'm going to change my black to white. I'll select both pieces and then I'll flatten them. So now we have our print and cut with a sticker outline. So those are three different ways to add a sticker outline depending on what type of graphic you have on hand. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.